USA's graduating performing unit is Division I-3A. Division I-3A provides the recruit choir, drill team, and band for today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions, right, face, section leaders, fall out and collect outer garments.
Set, left, carry, on. Forward, platoon, formation, march.
Divisions.
Counter.
March. Thank you. Rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm Lieutenant John Gaffer, Recruit Training Command's Drill Division Officer. I'd like to welcome you to today's passenger interview. Today, you will see 12 divisions comprised of 876 sailors participating in their graduation ceremony and soon to join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit position at center deck. There is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Seaman Recruits Alexander Kinney from Drake, Massachusetts. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is the State Flight Unit under 8th Training, the Staff Unit under 9th Training, and the Triple Threat Unit under 10th and final week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, recruits are placed in the divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This senior recruit supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commander. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will be starting from there. Division 2, 8-9, commanded by Petty Officer First Class Crystal Langiano. Petty Officer First Class Jason Moore. Petty Officer First Class Don Levins. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Aaron Hope Bivens from Whitwell, Tennessee. Division 2, 9-0, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Jax Gottenfoss. Petty Officer First Class Mercedes Logan. Petty Officer Second Class Thomas Walker. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Fireman Kyler Weary from Houston, Texas. Division 2, 9-1, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Daniel Hewitt. Petty Officer First Class John Porter. Petty Officer Second Class Laura Perez. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Jacob Watson from Copper's Cove, Texas. Division 2, 9-2, commanded by Petty Officer First Class Chelsea Collins. Petty Officer First Class James Krachenko. Petty Officer Second Class Jamie Naley. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Tiana Holmes from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Division 2, 9-3, commanded by Petty Officer First Class Andy Almonte. Petty Officer First Class Alexander Benrick. Petty Officer Second Class Joseph Johnson. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Fireman Apprentice Trent Rocket from Clarksville, Tennessee. Division 2, 9-4, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Luis Garza. Gavin Lacoste from Kings Mills, Ohio. Division 2, 9-5. Manhunt, Chief Petty Officer Gawain Allison. Petty Officer First Class, Michelle Harmony. Petty Officer Second Class, Jarvis Walker. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Emmanuel Wilson from Cairo, Georgia. Division 2, 9-6. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Edgar Gutierrez. Petty Officer First Class, Ryan Scheidel Dalby. Petty Officer Second Class, Sierra Morish. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Recruit Seth Hill from Salinas, California. Division 2, 9-7. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Derek McCleary. Petty Officer First Class, Carlos Ganasavilla. Petty Officer Second Class, Jordan Hunter. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Apprentice Jeremy Peters from St. Martin, Virgin Islands. Division 2, 9-8. Commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Harry Meyer. Petty Officer First Class, Andrew Piazza. Petty Officer Second Class, Jake Morton. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman Apprentice Jalen Merriweather from Alaska, Georgia. Division 2, 9-9. Commanded by Master Chief Petty Officer David Chapa. Petty Officer First Class, Dustin Jones. Petty Officer Second Class, Peter Schultz. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman J. Lenny Harvey from Atlanta, Georgia. Division 9, 3-8. Commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Benny Clark. Petty Officer Second Class, Kieran Connell. Petty Officer Second Class, Ronald Kuntman. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman Charles Halstead from Kenosha, Wisconsin. On behalf of the Commanding Officer and staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these division commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done.
Thank you.
please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party.
Time early. Strike the doorbell.
Recruit training command, arriving.
Governor of Indiana, arriving.
Present. Arms.
Creativity and the grit to overcome the obstacles that they will face. Lord, thank you for for the families who have invested in them. Bless them as they send their children to live out this great calling. Bless these sailors with a heart to grow. Let them never be hungry to become something more tomorrow than they were today. Inspire them to lead. Inspire them to see challenges as opportunities. Let them not only be leaders in this institution, but leaders in their communities and their families. Wherever they go, let their impact be such that everyone will know that a sailor has been amongst them. We pray these things in your great and precious name. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, this morning we pause to reflect on the tragic events of September 11, 2001. In the United States Armed Forces, retreat accompanies the security of the American flag and signals the end of the duty day. It provides an opportunity for honoring the flag, taking pride in rendering honors, proper respect, and to recognize the freedom for which it stands. At the ceremony of retreat, the flag is lowered, folded into a triangle fold, the red and white stripes folded into the blue, like the light of the day vanishing into darkness at night. It is kept under watch throughout the night as a tribute to our nation's honored dead. The next morning, it is brought out as a ceremonial reveille, signaling the start of a duty day, and runs the law, the symbol of our belief in the resurrection of the body. The flag-holding ceremony represents the same religious principles on which the freedoms of our country was originally founded. The portion of the flag, denoting honor, is the canton of blue containing stars, representing the states of the veterans of all generations who served in uniform. The canton field of the blue addresses from left to right, and it is inverted when draped as a pall on a casket of a veteran who has served our country in uniform and gave the ultimate sacrifice in defense for our freedoms. The first pole, in honor of the 13 original colonies and our forefathers who founded this great nation, we salute you. The second pole, to the men and women who died in the War of Independence, we salute you. The third pole, to those men who fell in the War of 1812 to preserve our freedom, we salute you. The fourth pole, to the brave soldiers on both sides of the North and South of the Civil War, we salute you. The fifth pole, to those who shed blood in the name of hope and freedom in the Great War, we salute you. The sixth pole, for those who have gone before us and died in terrible battles of Pearl Harbor, Midway, the Battle of the Bulge, Iwo Jima, Normandy, and Berlin, we salute you. The seventh pole, to the men of the 1st Marine Division, who in rear guard action at the chosen reservoir of Korea saved their battalion and the lives of their fellow Marines, we salute you. The eighth pole, for the brave men and women of the armed forces who died in the field of Vietnam, whose names live on forever in the hallowed wall, we salute you. The ninth pole, for those who lost their lives and suffered by the horrific, unspeakable terrorist acts of September 11, and those who continue to pay and sacrifice during post 9/11, we salute you. The 10th pole, for our emergency response personnel, on-site first responders, police, firefighters, paramedics, doctors, and nurses, we salute you. The 11th pole, to God, our parents, and our families who we love and respect, we salute you. The 12th pole, to the men and women of our armed forces, the arsenal of democracy and the hammer of freedom, we salute you. The 13th pole, to freedom, because without freedom, there is no honor. And on this we vow, as long as this flag flies, we salute you. When the flag is finally folded, the stars are upwards, reminding us of our nation's motto, In God We Trust. It takes on the appearance of a triad, reminding us of the soldiers who served under General George Washington and the sailors and Marines who served under Captain John Paul Jones. and those who have followed the armed forces of the United States, preserving all of our rights and privileges and freedoms that we enjoy today. On September 11th, the United States suffered the deadliest terror attack in world history, and the world was forever changed. Four planes were used as weapons of terror and carried out suicide attacks on targets including the World Trade Center in New York City, the Pentagon just outside of Washington, D.C., and the fourth plane that crashed in the field in Pennsylvania. Almost 3,000 people were killed and more than 6,000 were injured, including more than 400 law enforcement and firefighters. Receiving the flag this morning is Officer Gary Greer, North Chicago Police Department.
There's two left four, President Caterpillar, sir! Good morning. I'm Commander Rick Charter, Executive Officer of Recruit Training Command. On behalf of our commanding officer, Captain Kirkrick Brooks, I'm pleased to welcome families and friends to our graduation ceremony and look forward to sharing this momentous occasion with you. With us today is our reviewing officer, the Honorable Eric J. Holcomb, Governor of Indiana. Our guest of honor, Mr. Manuel Mercia, Director of 980 HR Enterprise Support. And our special guest, Captain Mark Zemetis, Executive Officer of the Naval Station Great Lakes. I would also like to welcome our first responders from our surrounding Great Lakes community. Today, as we remember all of those who lost their lives on September 11, 2001, we recognize our first responders. These individuals took an oath to protect and serve no matter how horrific the circumstances, putting themselves in harm's way so others may live. And for this, I am greatly appreciative and humbled to be in their presence today. To our families here today, I cannot thank you enough for your continued support, and I'm sure your sailors are grateful for your encouragement throughout your training here at Recruit Training Command. Lastly, I would also like to welcome all of the veterans in our audience and thank them for their service to our country. Would all of our veterans please stand, and let's give them a round of applause.
Thank you.
Having scored during recruit training and construction, Madison O'Brien, Division 289, from Murfreesboro, Tennessee, has earned the Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the Lake Lion Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of American Revolution. Construction and O'Brien receives a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, Sailor.
Airman
Jacobus Sherrill, Division 299, from Walterboro, South Carolina, is a recipient of the Military Order of the World War II of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during recruit training. Airman Sherrill is presented with a commemorative plaque from the Military Order of the World War II. Well done, Sailor. Recruit Training Command salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor.
Salute you. full steam ahead, Navy, a force for good, and the responsibility that comes with it. As a history buff, I can't help but note it was no coincidence that our nation earned and maintained our independence only after the U.S. Navy was founded. And now fast forward to your home. As your family and friends and loved ones and veterans that you have earned their respect look on, grateful that you are carrying on this tradition of excellence and service that has indeed defined our Navy for nearly 2.5 centuries. I have no doubt you are trained and you are ready to make your own mark, knowing whatever you give the Navy, you will be in receipt tenfold. You have earned something so special, evidenced by the fact that so many good and honorable Americans have lived their lives wondering if they'll ever make a meaningful difference. Men and women, you will never have that wonder. You have done it, and you are on your way to doing it again and again and again. In the days ahead, great things will be after you. Some we know, some we don't yet. And I know you will continue to step up and answer that call. Your cause is just. Your mission is noble. So as you pack your sea bag or walk across the street to your next duty, to your next school, and hone your talents that you have learned over the past weeks here, as you pursue your passion, please know, on behalf of 6.8 million patriotic Hoosiers, we are grateful for you. We congratulate you and your families and your support network for your service and sacrifice today and in all the days to come. I trust in the good Lord above, and I trust in every one of you. My beautiful bride and I will put you on our prayer list. We will pray that you have fair winds and following seas, successful missions, and always return home safely. God bless you all, our Navy, and may God continue to bless the United States of America.
Thank you.
Officer, Commander Charco. Please remain seated until your graduates is placed on liberty.
Thank you.
Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy Days. Can I ask that you remain indoors taking photos with your Navy sailor at this time? If you would like to exit into the parking garage, please use the south side doors that you came in. Whenever you depart, if you'd like to take photos of our memorial along the sailing walkway, please exit out the fourth garage door. And without further delay, now hear this. Liberty!